Yes. Yes. Correct.
Those shoes are amazing.
Thank you very much.
Excellent.
Show everybody those shoes.
Come on, show everybody those shoes.
We don't want to get them into Castilla.
Shoes. Like Elton John's shoes. They're great.
Thank you.
Every time I have been here, I have had the most extraordinary welcome. I would go as far as to say that the welcome I receive when coming here to Korea is the best in the world. And I'm not just saying that. It's absolutely the truth. And it's always very flattering and very humbling.
This is my second time here, and I only ever seem to be here for 12 or 16 hours, which is just heartbreaking. I'm lucky enough to come with my wife this time as well, who's been out all day yesterday visiting sites. She's convinced that we have to come back here now for our great holiday of 6 weeks or something. But, yeah, I just want to come here and stay longer every time I do. And as Terrence says, the welcome of the fans is incredible.
We just knew from the offset that we were very, very passionate about the story. It's the story of an extraordinary man, larger than life, an extremely colourful figure. And his life has been an extraordinary one. Although I'm speaking, I'm not going to claim this, it's Dexter's vision, but we always wanted to tell the story in an elevated way, in a very heightened, stylized way. And the film is also a musical. So we have somewhere in the region of 20 of Elton's classic songs in the film, and we use them to tell the story. That was something that's always been very appealing to me because I'm a singer. But undoubtedly, you're right, that does present challenges. The challenges are many, they're varied, and essentially it just means that you have to be very switched on, very on your game every single day. And it's always creativity that solves problems. It's always being creative, being available, being alive to the challenges. They're the things that allow you to circumnavigate the difficulties.
I can only just echo again what Taryn says so brilliantly. It was an incredible challenge, but we did have this incredible catalogue of music that Elton kind of gifted us and allowed us to use in a way that we needed to, that we saw fit, how we wanted to express the emotions of the characters in the film at any given time. And what you discover is you look deeper and deeper into the lyrics and the music that Elton and Bernie Taupin created, that there's this incredible storytelling there. And because we were given this creative freedom and the support of Sir Elton, Taron has this incredible instrument with his voice as well, which he uses throughout the film. We pre-recorded some of the music, but Taron, rightly so, insisted that when the opportunity arose that he would sing live on set. And this gives the film this authenticity, and we just count ourselves extremely fortunate that Elton is here to give us his blessing and his thoughts and his music, and then the freedom to be as creative as we needed to be with that.
Elton has been very, very present throughout the process. We're very, very fortunate in that Elton has, on one hand, been very available to us for us to be able to ask him questions, to get his approval for elements of the storytelling. But he's also afforded us the space to be creative, to have fun, to not feel too much pressure. And I really think that has been key and integral to why the movie is, I believe, a triumph. So I can only thank Sir Elton John. So yes, Elton and I first met on Kingsman: The Golden Circle. At that point, I still am a fan, but that was the only relationship I really had with him, just being one of millions of fans. And I was very nervous to meet him, understandably, because he's an icon. But one of the most refreshing things about meeting him and getting to know him and portraying him, which has meant that I've had a lot of contact with him, is just how kind he is, warm, full of love, and interested in me and interested in other elements of my life. I'm very, very proud and happy to say that we have become friends. And that's not something I ever expected from this process. I loved it. I absolutely loved it. It may have rubbed off on me slightly, actually. Julian Day, our costume designer, has done the most extraordinary work in this film. And for me as an actor, to have the gift of these costumes, they are such a phenomenal toolkit, and they're such a phenomenal facilitator for the performance I wanted to give. And frankly, had the costumes not been as wonderful as they are, I wouldn't have found it half as easy, and I highly doubt I would have, you know, given the performance that I wanted to give.
Elton John, as Tarrant said, is an extraordinary man, and the more you get to know him, the more that... But what the film tries to reflect is our impressions of him, as we understand to be this incredibly generous, funny, clever, quirky, unusual, colourful, vibrant. And the film does everything it can to try and reflect him as a person, as we know him, as we love him and understand him. And when you watch the film, you hopefully feel you get to know Elton John, the real Elton John. That's what's really important to us, and what's important to Elton. And the film is made up of his recollection and his memories. So it's all very much, very personal to him. And we feel the film is a very personal tribute to him. It really has the Sir Elton John in its DNA. It's really important that that's what we get. So you don't get a kind of removed kind of third person point of view, but you're in there. And I suppose you can take it many different ways, what it is to be a rocket man. Sometimes it's a lonely place that you fly up to and you're there all alone, but at the same time you're giving all this gift of light and colour and magic to the world. There's many reasons why it's called Rocket Man. So you should go and see all the many reasons why.
Of course, you know, to echo what I said at the start of this press conference, this part of the world has special relevance for me because of the success of my calling card film, Kingsman: The Secret Service, and then Kingsman: The Golden Circle. It's always a pleasure to come back. I'm always bowled over when I step off that plane here in Seoul, because I know something of what it feels like to be in One Direction for a moment. But it is absolutely fantastic to be here. Thank you for the wonderful response, and thank you for your time.
I'm just really proud to be stood next to this man here for the second time round for my visit to Korea. And if he's in One Direction, that means I get to be his old fat friend who stands by him. And that makes me extremely proud. There's nothing greater than coming to somewhere that's just full of enthusiasm and appreciation and excitement for what it is that he does next. And Tara and I intend to make many more films together. We'll always bring them back here. This is a great place for us to come. But we are extremely proud of Rocket Man. And Taron has an incredible voice, as well as an incredible ability to act. And these two things combined in Rocket Man is just something that we are so really personally proud of and are so excited to share with everyone. And of course, we encourage you to go and see it. Go and see it 5 times. We hope that you love it as much as we do and you go with all your friends.
Go and see it 6 times.
6 times. And then if you all do that, we'll definitely come back again. But thank you. You make us feel so welcome.
Kamsahamnida. Thank you very much.